Hi everyone, welcome to the Spring SMC Film Club Festival for 2020.
We're super excited to see what you guys have to submit. I know I, for one, can speak for the entire club when I say I am really proud that you guys muzzled through and made these shorts that we're about to see today.
Really happy to see. Oh, damn. We're super excited to see what you guys have submitted. It's our last meeting, so it's kind of like bittersweet to be here with you guys, but we're really honored to be the people who, you know, got to help see the club through this transition from what it was before to, you know, what it is now, at least until we're back on campus. So, you know, we're really glad to see that you guys have still been creating in these crazy times.
Yeah. And I want to thank all of you guys for bearing with us when we were trying to, when we first started the semester off and we had all been switched from all classes, and just want to thank you guys for bearing with us. We really appreciate it. And we're super excited for the next semester and have full trust in our new board and have, and seeing what they can do to push the club forward.
But, you know, we are really going to miss you guys, and we're going to miss, you know, coming to the meetings every Friday and you know, getting to see what you guys create and make fun challenges for everyone. So, you know, we wish you luck in the festival and then just in everything in general. And, you know, we can't wait to hopefully see you guys next semester online on the Zoom Club. So without further ado, we will hand it off to our boys, Jason and Dom, to get started with the festival.
Thank you. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Check it out. Let's go. What is going on? What is going on? What is going on? What is going on? Going on, going on, going on, going on, going on. Let's go.
Placed under arrest. You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be used against you in a court of law. You have the right to an attorney. If you cannot afford an attorney, one will be appointed for you.
Thank you.
Some people hate what I wear. Some people praise it. Some people use it to shame others. Some people use it to shame me. But I feel you watching. Always. And nothing I do goes unseen. So while I feel your stares, your disapproval, or your sigh of relief, if I lived by them, I'd never be able to move. Would you like me to be smaller, weaker, softer, taller? Would you like me to be quiet? Do my shoulders provoke you? Does my chest? Am I my stomach? My hips? The body I was born with? Is it not what you wanted? If I wear what is comfortable, I am not a woman. If I shed the layers, I'm a slut. Though you've never seen my body, you still judge it, and judge me for it. Why? We make assumptions about people based on their size. We decide who they are. We decide what they're worth. If I wear more, if I wear less, who decides what that makes me? What that means? Is my value based only on your perception? Or is your opinion of me not my responsibility?
Hello, everyone. If you're watching this video today, then you're probably wondering what this is. Well, today I'm going to tell you the two ways to stay clean during the pandemic. There is the conventional way. And the unconventional way.
You left me no choice! I didn't
do it! Now, after this video, try either one of these methods and see if either of them work. Thank you.
Tapping the barn into ya.
Who are you? What are you doing here?
Well, laddie, my name's Plastered, and I work for Lucky, the leprechaun at Lucky Charms.
We're in fucking quarantine. Get the fuck out. What the fuck? Why are you censoring me?
This commercial is rated PG.
What commercial?
You're the lucky winner of a gourmet serving of Lucky Charms.
No.
But I'm not allowed to leave you till I serve you some of my yummy deliciousness.
I don't even have any milk or cereal. What the fuck? I'm not gonna eat that.
Sit down! Enjoy your meal!
Alright, alright. Oh my god! Thank you so much!
My name is Kayla and Jerry, and I am a dreamer. I have always been a daydreamer, going through life lost in thought, dreams of being a superhero, a doctor saving a patient, traveling the world, and being loved light of the moon rises in the sky and I succumb to the inevitable slumber. Vacancy is the only face that greets me. But when the blinding light of the sun comes up and shines down on my skin, I feel the brewing of ideas almost sizzling in my brain, ready to be taken off the heat and plated to the world. Keep dreaming. Dreams are the mystery of our mind and soul, showcasing our fears and desires. A creative, an entertainer, an artist, labels I have decided to claim on my being and soul. I am who I am. My dreams are who I might be.
Hey, Pa.
Hey, mijos. Just wanted to call and see how my son's doing.
I'm doing good. Got my AC fixed in the house.
Good for you. How's your car running?
Good. I love that little car. For a minute there, I was contemplating sleeping in it because the AC in there works like a charm.
Yeah, don't ever do that, okay? That's how you kill yourself. The carbon monoxide's poisonous.
I know. I'm just kidding.
Well, that's not something you should kid about. Well, my little car is running good. I just took it to the car wash. You know me. I can't drive around a dirty car. Now I just gotta wax it and she's good to go. How's your car looking?
It could use a wash.
You're just like your mom and your sisters. Always driving a filthy car. I don't know how you guys can do that.
You know, I can honestly say I'm real proud of your older brother. Because he always keeps his car clean.
I know, even his shoes stay clean.
Hey, speaking of shoes, how do you like your new Pumas?
How'd you know?
I picked them out. Your mom didn't tell you?
No. Guess she wants all the credit. I got them right here, though. I love them.
Sounds like your mom. What was that? Somebody's calling you?
Yeah, just my new girlfriend, but I'll call her back later.
Oh, you got a new girlfriend, huh? Who is she?
Her name's Brianna.
Is she pretty?
Yeah, she's beautiful.
Now let me ask you this. What color is she?
Why does that matter?
Is she black?
Yeah, she is, but why does that matter though?
That matters a lot to me. You saw what happened to your older sister when she tried to come home with the black boyfriend. I didn't talk to her for years, and now you want me to do that to you too?
Well, I guess I'll have to accept that. Why should I have to choose the person that I end up spending the rest of my life with based off your preferences? It's my life, it's my decision.
Yeah, but why do they have to be black though? Can't you bring home a nice little Mexican girl?
I like black girls. The blacker the berry, the sweeter the juice.
I know you think this is real funny, but I'm not joking.
Well, that's what I'm attracted to. They're beautiful. And you have no idea how good of a person she is. You haven't even asked me anything about her. She served in the army just like you. She comes from a good home where family's everything, just like us. She even speaks Spanish, just like you. Her family comes from Belize, which is right next to Mexico. You want me to show you a picture of her? She's really pretty. Dad, seriously, why you gotta be like that?
You know what's gonna happen, right?
Yeah, you're never going to talk to me again. I get it.
You're going to make me and your mom get a divorce.
Are you serious?
She's going to choose you over me, and we're going to have to get a divorce because you wanted to marry a black girl.
Well, then I'm going to have to accept that and live with it.
I can't believe you. You disappoint me, son. You really want me to disown you, huh?
I should be able to choose the person I want to spend the rest of my life with.
Well, I'm going to write you out of my will then. And you won't hear from me the rest of your life.
So be it, but I won't ever stop loving my father because I love you. I love you, Dad, no matter what. I have to accept you for who you are, and if you choose to never talk to me again and hate my guts, I'm still gonna love you.
Well, I don't love you.
You don't love me.
Nope. You can go die.
What?
You can go die, and I won't even care.
You want me to die?
Yep.
You want me to kill myself?
Yeah, I don't care. Go kill yourself.
Well, I still love you. And if you think that you can bring me down, you're wrong. I don't sacrifice my happiness for no one. I'm gonna live a happy life with or without your love and consent.
Well, you won't ever see me again. And if you have kids, I won't ever acknowledge them either. They won't ever have me in their life.
Well, then I'm gonna have to accept that.
If I was right there, I'd knock your teeth down your throat. Don't talk to me. Don't look at me. Don't do anything. Just keep being the same piece of trash you are. Now hit the bricks.
How do you change someone's mind? Calling someone out usually just leads to an argument, which most often results in nothing being changed. But how do we end racism? Your blood may be boiling after watching this, and maybe you're thinking of something you would say in retaliation. But chances are, your points would just fall on deaf ears. Instead of telling somebody they're racist, maybe it's best to just talk to them about how their words are impacting you and how you truly feel. Let's speak up.
could you, like, bring a tire?
I forgot the spare wheel.
Oh.
2 minutes late. You're fired.
Go, amigo.
Thanks, but I'll stick back here for a while.
All right, but you owe me like 80 bucks.
Thank you. Yeah, you got any more waters? Yeah, real funny.
Yo, I cannot find anything good to drink. What is that?
Oh, this is a Trippin drink. It's a new drink.
What is that? What do you mean?
Oh, it's a drink. When you're drinking, you trip. So I'm sitting down.
Okay.
Yeah, that's true. Do you want to try it?
Can I have it?
Careful, yeah. It's pretty good. Mm-hmm.
Okay, weirdo.
Inside my body there lives a little man. He uses my body as a three-flat. Every day he wakes up rubbing his tired eyes. He eats breakfast and gets to work. Taking the elevator made from my lungs, every inhale taking him down, every exhale taking him up. At the top he goes to a skull wall and flips the light on. The lights roar on then die. He flicks the switch a couple more times. Nothing. He lets out a long sigh. He goes to the hatch at the base of my brain. He crawls through and then stands up in the next room. Every surface covered in dust. On the floor lie huge cables connecting my body to my brain. At the far end of the room lay a circuit box. He flips one of the switches. The box sparks. He jolts back and pulls the huge lever atop the box. Crawling back through the hatch, he goes to the switch on the skull wall. The lights come on with a faint buzzing sound. With a few clicks of the keys, my body comes fluttering, shaking, then roaring to life. Walking to the front of my brain, he pulls the cord on the shutters. My eyes open, light comes pouring in. Walking to another room, he goes through the red curtain. On the other side, there is a wall of TVs. Adjacent filing cabinets line the room, filled with VHSs containing my memories. Rifling through them, he decides which to play for the day. Popping them in, he hits the repeat button. Using my vertebrae, he climbs down to my chest, heading to wake up the biggest criminal ever known, who grew up sentenced to life in maximum security prison known as my ribcage. Broken out before, he's managed to escape more times than recorded. The escape artist known as my heart, gently reminding me of all the failed love I've ever had. The man searches my heart to make sure he doesn't have any tricks up his sleeve.
Get up.
After doing so, he is locked back up again. As he walks down the hall, my heart lets out a shriek of laughter that echoes through my veins. The man doesn't say a word. The leaky vein, he patches it with an old washcloth and some duct tape. An alarm goes off. He goes back up to my brain where the corner lay a room, the walls covered in photos of people that I put my heart into, then they break it. On the floor lay a new stack of photos. Slowly, one by one, he pins each photo on the wall. After a few more hours of maintenance, it's time to shut down. He goes up to the top floor, pulls the blinds behind my eyes down, takes the VHSs out, and puts them away. As he cleans up a bit more, he goes to turn the huge lever off. My body shuts down, then the switch. My brain goes dark. He says goodnight to my heart, then takes the elevator down to his room, undresses, lies down, and quickly drifts to sleep. The man searches my heart to make sure he doesn't tricks up his sleeve.
Sorry about that. Wow, guys, that was great. I loved, there wasn't a thing I didn't love just now. Every short was great. Great job, everyone.
Yeah, it was amazing seeing, you know, what everyone did, you know, with what they had and, you know, getting really creative with the challenges that we had. I saw a lot of really great Yolipos in there and, you know, that was amazing.
I'm speechless. That was amazing. Do we want to start off the voting, Dom and Jason?
Yes, Dom will take us away. He'll explain how the voting's going to work, how we're going to get through to you guys. So without further ado, Dominic, take us away.
All right, nice. Okay, so hi, guys. My name is Dominic, like Ario said. And if you guys look in the YouTube, I think it's somewhere over here, the YouTube little live chat, you will see a little a Google Doc that will have basically all the categories and forms, or all the categories of every single film that was put in the summit today. And you guys can vote on what was your favorite ones. And then after our little Q&A that we're going to start here in a minute, we'll get those results then. So we have, to kind of start off the Q&A, we have some people who have submitted some stuff that are in for a live Q&A, and we're going to start off with some questions. So I'm going to bring in Mariana, and then I have someone named Jasper. I'm just going to bring you guys in real quick, and then you guys can say like what films you guys submitted. Okay, can you hear me, Mariana? Oh, Mariana. Oh, can you hear me? Can you hear me, Mariana?
Mariana, can you hear us? Okay.
Now I can. Yeah.
Okay. Cool. Okay. So you submitted a film. What film did you submit?
What time?
What film did you submit for the festival?
Oh, the Humanity.
Humanity. Okay. And then I'm just gonna introduce everyone real quick. So just kind of going to run down.
I got in late, so I'm not sure. I didn't even see it.
Yeah. No, you're fine. I'm just gonna introduce everyone real quick, and then I'll ask you guys questions, and I can shoot back some questions to you guys from the audience if I see any. Kayla, you want to go next? You want to introduce yourself? There we go. Oh, you got it? Make sure everyone's unmuted.
Okay.
All right. Yeah, you can introduce yourself.
Okay. Hi, my name is Kayla and Jerry. I'm a freshman. Well, now I'm going to be a sophomore at SMC. I like learning languages, I guess. I'm an actor, but I decided let me do film stuff and just try it out. And that's how I got to be in SMC Film Club.
Nice. And then Zander, you want to introduce yourself and the film or films that you submitted to the assembly today?
Hey, I'm Zander. This is my last semester at SMC. I'm graduating in a few weeks. I'm a theater arts major and I guess minor in film. I was part of the promo pathway program with Dominic. So my Lucky Charms commercial was the first challenge of the 1 minute film. And so it was like a fun idea I came up with one of my roommates. And then the protest film I did was the Lupo challenge, and my handicaps were, there had to be a single shot of like one person in the shot at some point. There had to be some sort of wheel. So like the car wheels satisfied that. And then this is it's really funny. I originally thought, like, because I hadn't looked at my challenge email for a while, I thought my third challenge was a line of dialogue had to be, "I'll have what she's having," from like Harry Mathiali. Yeah. But and so I had an idea for that. And then literally like some point, like 2 days ago, whatever, I'm like, she's a gold digger. So I'm like, how am I gonna make that work with like such serious content? Like, oh my God.
Yeah.
So of course I knew about that song, but I was like, oh, it's not really appropriate, different things. And so that was the Glee version of the little audio clip that I put in that, it's a little acapella before like the beat comes in and it turns into the rap and everything. So, So I did the best I could with trying to make this like funny line flow.
And we're gonna get back to like what was your thought process about the whole thing?
Supposed to be just introduction.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Yeah, no, it's all good. What I left off. Oh yeah, Steven. Yeah, so Steven, you want to introduce yourself in the film that you released? Oh, all right. Are you able to unmute yourself? I think I hit the setting.
There we go. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Yeah, so I'm Steven Almanza, and these last few several days I've been working on more than just that film. I actually made a music video about what's going on in the world. It's called No Room for Racism. The film that I did for this was the Ulipo Challenge, and it's called FaceTime. And unfortunately, what you saw was a true story. So hate to say it, but yeah, I've dealt with my dad being prejudiced since I was a baby, but we're still trying to change him. So we're still working on it. You know, it's just there's only so much you can do. We've learned you can't argue, because I mean, you can read many books on, you know, how you talk to people and how you influence them, and arguing is not the answer. Arguing just makes them argue back and hold to their stance even firmer, and they'll defend themselves even more. So unfortunately, you know, we're still coping with all that. I myself dealt with what you saw in that video just about 3 weeks ago. So.
All right. Yeah. So we appreciate all of you guys submitting something for the festival today. And kind of to loop back to Kayla, because I saw your comment that you forgot to talk about your film. I'll start with you. So like, what was your inspiration behind your film? What was your thought process just going into it? Like, just like, why did you want to like make this film? Yeah. Okay. Yeah, there we go. Yeah.
So I just was feeling a little insecure and something one day, and I was like, because acting, I auditioned and I didn't book something. So I was like, ugh. So I was like, I'm going to stop waiting to book something and I'm going to create something. And it was actually the day we had film club, and I was like, what would I put better use in this time? I was like, let me just film something. So in front of my house, I was just like, let me just film stuff. So I got my tripod, went around my block and neighborhood, and filmed a couple shots, and I thought it could be kind of I called it DayDreamer, is what I had the idea for it. Like,
You good.
There's like daydreaming and like how I've been doing that lately and things I want in my career. And so I thought, let me just give some inspiration, especially it was like right before everything was kind of happening. I just thought to hold on to your dreams, and that's kind of when I did the voiceover. But I filmed and edited in one day on Final Cut Pro, and like my iPhone, I filmed it on, And that was kind of surreal, but it just shows how much work goes into like being a director, a cinematographer, crafty services, if you saw in my...
Yeah.
Sorry, I was being quirky. but yeah, that's pretty much my inspiration and stuff. And I just like kind of utopia, not utopia. I mean, I didn't give that vibe because I only had a couple materials, but I love like a soft aesthetic kind of vibe. And I think I gave it with the little materials I had.
Nice. And then I'm going to Zander, like same question. Like, what was your inspiration in making this film, or like doing that video that you showed?
So for Protoast?
Yeah.
I mean, what people should know about me of like, I'll just talk about my first one for a second of like, I'm an actor too, and I really dig very like experimental avant-garde stuff. I love just like weirdness and creativity. And so I'm like whoever, I forget which person's the cut of like the remix of The King's Speech, like stuff like that, like Max's like noir, really like up there stuff. Like I love just doing unconventional stuff. And so my Lucky Charms thing was similar to that. But since this whole like new civil war, basically, like we really are at war with the police right now and like Trump and the government and stuff, this new like Black Lives Matter stuff, I've become so serious. Like all I'm doing is talking about like all these themes to people. That's all I'm like posting on social media right now. Like it's very like different for me of just like only like taking these matters like seriously and really advocating for what's going on. And so I was filming a lot of protest footage and marches in general. And I have some different ideas for some different projects that I'm going to do with some of the footage, including like a music video-esque thing. Like I'm really interested in seeing your concept, Stephen. Because I have ideas of doing similar stuff. And yeah, so it was cool having those guidelines for the Lipo challenge. Cause when I have a couple of tasks, then that really can get my creativity flowing of like, oh, how am I gonna make this all work? As opposed to just like, it's up in the air, do your thing. Which I mean, it's also cool. But yeah, I always knew that footage of I'm forgetting her name. I'd have to look her up on Instagram. The one that was saying like, hands up, I can't breathe. I mean, I'm sure some of you were getting chills by the different footage and that clip and everything. But I can tell you, just being right next to her in person and just all of us and everything, it was one of the most chilling, haunting experiences of my life. I felt so vulnerable. Like here we were just like for 2 minutes just saying like our hands up, I can't breathe, everything with like all these police officers. I feel LA has been one of the most come around cities in the US of like major cities that I'd say since like last Wednesday, which was when I started like regularly attending protests and marches, that the police have become very supportive of just like understanding where people are coming from, or just at the very least indifferent about things, mm-hmm. or just being professional. Okay. Sorry, I'm trying to
remember. No, you're good. Yeah.
Damn, sorry, Dominic was telling me to wrap it up.
It's okay. Like I have another question for you. So if you want to like think about it, like I can come back because I'm a lap around everyone with the same question. Yeah. So Cyrus, your film. You want to introduce your film? Like just talk about who you are, what's your name, and then what your film was that you submitted.
Sure thing. So first off, hey everybody, how's it going? So I am a veteran of the SMC Film Club. So if I was going there back from 2013 to 2015. So, and since then I transferred to California Institute of the Arts. Graduated with a film video, like a BFA there, and currently attending Loyola Marymount University, studying film production there. So as some of you could probably tell, that was my film that I made back in spring of last year. So for just my film production program and stuff, and that was not the version intended to be screened here and stuff. I was trying to submit the final cut of the film and stuff, but I sent it out to everybody and stuff, so in case if anybody is like curious to see that. And so it's this film found soul. It's kind of like a personal, like a film, like based off of me trying to find my own passion in life, but working at a job that I'm not passionate about and stuff. So this film was like partially inspired by that and stuff, as well as just being curious about like the perspective of my dad's coworkers stuff, who my dad also actually works in drywall and stuff. So so like the people that have worked with my dad, and how I've been curious to know like how they feel about working with him. It's also partially based off of their perspective. So yeah.
All right. So thank you for that. And I'm gonna come back to everyone with the same question too. Mariana. Oh, Mariana. Can you hear us?
Hello.
Okay. Cool. Okay, so same question that that I asked Kayla, like, what was your inspiration for making this film?
Well, for making Humanity, so yeah. We actually didn't have any inspiration. We were just quarantined, me and my friend, like my best friend, and then we went like, cause we live in a place there are a lot of forest here in Brazil. And then we decided to create something like, let's just do something fun. And then we went to the forest, in the middle of the forest, and we tried to do anything with an iPhone, and that's it. And we did it in like 1 hour.
With an iPhone?
With an iPhone. That was nice. Basically it. Like just me and him, and literally it.
Nice. It came out really good too.
Thank you. We tried our best. We were just like making fun and let's create something. And then we decided.
Yeah, we love that energy. Just, you know, just go out to create just to create. So we love that. All right, thank you. And then Naomi, can you hear us okay?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Okay, so first, can you like introduce yourself and what film or films that you submitted so far?
Yeah, sure. Mm-hmm. Can everybody hear me?
Yeah.
Okay. Hello everyone. My name's Naomi. My major is theater arts, and I'm also going to minor in film. And the films I submitted were My Sound Story, My Olipo, if that's how you pronounce it, My Olipo, which was Stay Clean. And then I also submitted Not My Responsibility, but like my version of it.
All right, nice. And then, what was your inspiration in making those films? Or you can, if you want to, you could just identify what your favorite film was, and like, what was your inspiration in making that, or your thought process behind it? Like anyone, like it doesn't have to be all three.
For the Stay Clean film, I was mostly inspired about, inspired from just everything going on, like with the coronavirus and how everything has been hectic these last few months. So I just kind of wanted to make something funny and positive out of it and sort of make it into a commercial. So that's when Stay Clean was born.
Nice. Thank you. And then who is next? Hello, Mike. Did you submit a film?
Actually, I filmed it as part of it, but I didn't finish the editing, so I could submit at the time. And this is my first semester at SMC, so there are many works.
But this is only for the people who submitted, because so you didn't submit a film for this festival, right?
I'm sorry.
Yeah, it's all good. Yeah. So yeah, just you can submit it to our next film festival, and that'll work out. Cool.
Okay.
Yeah. Sorry about that, man.
No. I'm sorry.
You good. All right. Okay. Pranchu, can you hear me?
Hi.
Okay. All right. You can hear us good?
Yeah. Loud and clear.
Okay, so question for you, just to introduce yourself first, like what's your name, and then what was the video that you submitted today?
Okay, my name is Pranchu Srivastava, and the video I submitted was the edit video, which was basically the King's Speech, just doing weird dances and mixes.
Nice. And then what was your inspiration behind that? Or actually, I mean, I kind of know
what the inspiration
was because it was an assignment, right? It was an assignment that you have for Wobbly, right? Yeah.
So this was an assignment for a class that was known as ET60. It's now in a different name now, starting this semester. It was called post-production projects. So our professor gave us this assignment where we're supposed to pick a movie and a song and make an edit out of it. But the song and the film cannot really match in a way. And that time I found this song called Fade Away by The Allergies, which is my favorite funk band now these days. And I saw a DJ did a remix of that. So I thought that was pretty cool. And I really wanted to do something that was like, really like just fun editing. Just, I really wanted to push how far I can go in terms of the editing. And I really like doing all these crazy kind of cuts. So I was like, I'll do that. And the film I decided to choose was The King's Speech. So it worked really well.
Nice. And then I'm gonna lap back one more time to you guys. So I'll start with you again, Pranchu, for my next question. What is something that you learn, or any reflections that you learned from this experience, or anything that you learned from this experience of doing these films? Like anything you learned new, or something you didn't know before, et cetera, et cetera. And that's the same question for all you guys as well. So I'll start with you, Pranchu.
Oh, I don't know.
For editing purposes, like, cause you edited that spot. So like, is there anything like editing wise that you learn, whether it's like organization, like, you know, like how long it takes to, you know, get a cut done, that kind of thing, you know, just anything that you may have learned.
I think the organization was probably the biggest thing I learned in this, because I had to cut something from like an hour and a half or maybe like 2 hours film into something that was just 1 minute and 45 seconds.
Right.
And it's really good to just keep it organized. So that way it also kind of helps you with your creative thoughts. Like eventually you can just keep looking back at it and you see, oh, I can work on this, I can work on that.
Mm-hmm.
And it really is just more fun when you just kind of like, if you feel like if you can do more and you try to do more, it just really works out, just to see how much you've learned or how much fun you enjoy all this. I mean, I had very limited time to work on this, only 9 days on an average of 3 hours.
Yeah.
And it takes, but it's like projects like these that kind of help me realize how much fun I have in doing editing.
Nice, nice, nice. I'm an editor too. So like I love to hear that. Like I love to edit. All right, thank you, Pranchu. And then I'll go with Mariana next. So same question. What is something that you learned from that experience of filming that film?
The thing is, I had a really hard time editing. I used Premiere Pro. That was like my first time editing, kind of, like a short. And it was so hard. And I had like limited time to edit. So I had one day to do all of this. And for the format and everything, it didn't come out the way I wanted. So I think for the next one, I need to have a little more time to edit and like do cut one and cut two and everything. Cause that was really the cut one, cause I didn't have time to do more than that. And that was basically it in audio and everything.
Yeah. So just next time, just making more time for yourself ahead of time.
Or just planning a little bit more too. Yeah.
Got you. I need to do the same thing too. Like time management is like so key. Yeah. So I feel you on that. All right. So thank you, Mariana. I appreciate that. Mm-hmm. And then next I'll go with Steven. Same question. Like anything you learned from that experience of shooting or like just like the thought process behind, or not the thought process, but just like after making that film or your film FaceTime, like is there anything that you learned, like new experiences or, you know, just anything? Oh, yeah.
Sorry, I have a lot of construction. Hopefully you guys, can you hear me okay with all this construction going on behind me?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, you know, I don't really make art. I make music, and I make films, right? And I don't really make my art to put out a message. I stopped doing that because I just want to have fun. And I realized making this and the last couple projects I've been working on that it's time to, you know, you got to also use your skills to do something at some point to help the world. You know, I'm never really trying to push messages on people in my music, for instance. You know, I make songs about, you know, dance songs. You know, I like, you know, fun songs to, you know, hang out with your friends and, you know, just party. But, you know, and films also, I usually like to just write horror films and comedies. But what I learned from this experience, because I've been so passionate about everything lately, is, you know, when you feel very passionate about something that you feel the world needs to hear, you know, focus all your energy on that. And that's definitely what I learned from this experience.
Nice.
As far as editing, I learned, I wanted to answer John Fiskay. I hope I'm pronouncing it right. John's question, he had asked me right here. I don't know if we're allowed to do that yet or.
Yeah, you can answer it. Yeah,
okay,
answer
so that question. He had asked me how I did the old man, my father in the video. And he'd asked me if it was makeup, and that was actually all through the Snapchat filter.
I turned on
Snapchat, put the old man filter on, and then recorded my screen and shot it shot it on my Android S7. All of this was shot on my Android Galaxy S7, which is like a 6-year-old phone now. And it still works like a charm. The only thing wrong with my phone, I've been shooting everything with it since I've got it. All my music videos. It's pretty low budget, but great. I mean, you gotta do what you gotta do. But the only thing wrong with the phone at this point is the battery. And I just ordered a replacement battery. So I'm going to have to tackle putting that in, but yeah, you got to do what you got to do with your equipment you have.
Yep. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. All right. We appreciate that, Steve. I appreciate it. All right. And then Zander, I'm going to go to you. What is something that you learned from this experience?
So that definitely ties in with what I was talking about in the first one, what I was saying, first of all, I don't know. I mean, like, obviously I'll never understand what it's like to be Black or like the different things. Like I've gone through like my own things of being part of the LGBT community and different things, but I don't know. I felt like I was sharing in that experience in certain ways of just what I was talking about in being with all those people, like right on the street saying, I can't breathe. And there was one other protest I was at where it was just like, it didn't really matter the color of your skin. There was potential of like any of us being shot. Like if we were in like another part of the US or whatever, just because speaking up about these issues or just being so like vulnerable of not part of the crowd, that like I learned from this about just being on the front line, being like, I don't know. I just was learning people's stories and just how brave people are. That's what I took away from this most, of just like learning people's stories, the bravery of everyone, that like this is more important than any single person, and that there's just so much potential of overlapping these narratives that it's there. Yeah, there's just so much important stuff to share, and
so much to learn and unpack.
Yeah, and it's just interesting how art is can be very creatively and flow like combined, that it's like, because I have like a bunch of footage and I just was going through stuff and I was like, oh, that connects to this and that, and like, wow, these things can piggyback off of each other. And it made me appreciate doing this, like the impact art can have in social change and awareness.
Nice. Okay, so what you took the most is just like learning and understanding that perspective. Like that's what you took from the most, just learning and listening.
Yeah, and just documenting everything on the front line, that like I kind of wanted to just give people the experience of as if they were there, especially like that I can't breathe when I was like right next to her, just filming all that. Powerful.
Nice. I could say, you know, from my perspective and person, like I appreciate that. Like just, you know, your willingness to learn and be there on the front line with us. So I appreciate that, just me personally. Thank you. All right, and then Kayla, I'm gonna come to you. So same question. What is something that you learned from this experience, whether it's production wise or even just like the message like that you had in the little video?
Okay. What I learned is I learned that production and filming and stuff, it's easy and hard at the same time. It was easy-ish to be like, I'm gonna film, I'm gonna put my camera tripod here, do this. But it was hard to like figure out sound and the beats and make sure it wasn't too loud, but it wasn't too soft. I still didn't think that. I thought my voice was a little too soft for the music I had. But I also learned that if I just gave myself a few moments to create, it could make something wonderful. So that's what I learned so far.
Nice. All right, appreciate that. And then Naomi or Cyrus, are you guys still there? If any of you guys want to answer any more questions. All right, so Cyrus, the same question that I asked Kayla and everyone else, like what was something that you learned from this experience of shooting the film that you showed?
Hey, well, as a current grad student at LMU still, I'm heading into my last year. That's when I pretty much learned all the very advanced methods of trying to go through the process of making a professional indie film. And so, and that is like filling out permits, submitting certain documents to the higher ups to get it greenlit, and auditioning your actors, rehearsing with them, and trying to pretty much do everything further in advance as possible. So as part of pre-production, as well as setting up your either a storyboard or an animatic and creating a lookbook for the film. All this I did for Bound Soul. So, and as of recently, I've been working really hard at editing up the final cut for the film. So yeah, it was a lot of work trying to get that in time for this festival. So, and because like I've had very fond memories with the SMC Film Festival in the past, they've been great at bringing a whole bunch of people and getting their films exposed and stuff years ago. So, and I feel like it would be very meaningful if I, just like I came back here to my old alma mater and just like submitting a film again for old time's sake, as well as just getting my work exposed. So,
yeah, no, we appreciate that. We appreciate you coming back.
Yeah.
All right, and also like we'll in our Discord too, like we'll drop everyone's movies in here too, so we'll like increase the exposure for people who couldn't be here, so we'll drop it in there too. Okay, so thank you, Cyrus, and then Naomi. Missing anyone else? I think you're the last one. Okay, so Naomi, so same question. What is something that you learned from shooting? Because you submitted, I think it was two or three for the festival. Like, what did you learn from doing all those projects? Like, what's something that you could take away from this experience?
Wow, this is kind of a lot to think about.
Sorry.
No, it's okay. I think what I can really take away from doing those three projects and then everything else I did for other film club challenges, I'm sorry, I'm really thinking. And
is there something that you think that you probably could have, like, is there like a shot or like a certain idea, like from like, let's say like the washing hands video, like was there something that maybe you wanted to like a joke that you wanted to put in there that you thought that would have worked better if you would have done that, like just something like that, like kind of something to kind of go off of?
Yeah, I think with when washing my hands, well, the washing my hands video, I feel like I could have put a lot more effort to make it more funny or I guess to like kind of put the point across, like, oh, you could do it, like you could stay clean like this or that, but also because I'm also a perfectionist, like with my work, and I'm still very new to filmmaking, and because of this, I'd say that it's just really important to like be able to work with what I got and to be able to keep motivating myself and encouraging myself that I can do this and that I could put enough effort and so forth into what I want to do to make this piece happen.
Nice. I like that message too. Like, just, yeah, like, cause I'm a perfectionist as well. Like, I was like, I'm always like very like, I should have like done this, or I should have done that. Like, I think we can all speak to that. Like, we're all like, as soon as we release something or if we like, as soon as we see the final cut, it's like, maybe we should have done this, whatever. So, but yeah, but for me, like just coming from me, like in my experience, like the most important thing is just like understanding that next time you'll do better. And if there's always going to be a next time, like there's always going to be a next project, and everyone, you know, we're all creatives here. So we're all going to like link up and do stuff. So that's one thing we want to like really embody, is just making sure that we never lose contact, and we all want to share ideas, link up and everything. So that's one thing that I want like everyone's kind of take away, is just like, don't lose contact, always create, and you know, we'll just make some magic together. Like that's my MO. And have fun, like how Steven said, just have fun. So yeah, so that's my little take on everything. But I'm getting a message that we're out of time for the Q&A. If you guys who are watching the stream right now, if you guys do have any more questions for any of the people that are here, we'll drop their emails and everything, or they'll drop their emails in the Discord and everything, if you guys want to ask more questions or link up for a project in the future, something like that. And we'll get you guys on that. And now we're going to transition to our next little segment, our second to last segment. We have Catherine Nilsson, who is our treasurer, and she has a little announcement talking about the a little up and coming club that is in the works. So I'm going to mute her.
Hey guys, it's Kat. First of all, it was really wonderful to see all of your work and also to hear your feedback on how you've you know, use the most of what you got. Honestly, we're all cut off at a certain length from being able to access what we need to, but still, like, we've managed to keep in contact and keep our projects planned. And so one of the good things that's come about this semester due to the digital remote learning environment is that we managed to intermingle with the other CMD clubs. And so I'm going to drop a link right now. This one is for a film club specifically, but if you guys check that link out later, there's a link at the bottom that says CMD community. So if you're curious about the other clubs, for example, John Fisk last week brought up the idea of having a documentary club. And we also kind of want to revamp the journalism club. So if you guys have footage or projects from like real life documentation and you haven't had the ability to like tie it into other projects, I think this would be a great opportunity for us as a campus to collaborate. And then one last thing, if there's any student leaders who will be around in the fall, we would love your help trying to create a central database website, as we've spoken about in the first mixer, a place where students from IXD, from theater, from all departments across the campuses can have a central place to communicate, because we've been so divided. It's just not given us the full potential that we could access. So I'm excited to see that now we're intermingling more, collaborating. So make sure to check out the Discord link to CMD community. And there's a collab requests thread in case you guys do have a project in the upcoming summertime that you wanna reach out to other like-minded students about. And yeah, other than that, thank you all and take care.
Okay. And then, okay. All right, back. All right. So, and then now we're going to go hand it off to Ariella and Max for our closing segments. And hold on one second. I gotta get the, what's it called? The results for the festival. Okay. All right. Yeah. So I'm gonna announce the winners first. So I guess I'll start with from bottom to top. So I'll start with best editing first. So we have our winner for best editing is going to be, drum roll please, and edited by Pranchu. So he will win best editing for his film or his video and edit, literally the title and edit, the best name ever. And then for best cinematography, another drum roll, we have Cyrus's Found Soul, one for best cinematography. And then I'll go to best Yulipo, and then another drum roll. So for best Yulipo, the winner is Steven's FaceTime. So he will win for best Yulipo. And then for our grand prize, we have for best picture, we have, okay, another drum roll. Zander's Lucky Charms commercial. And he won for best picture, which is our grand prize. So he is our ultimate grand prize winner. So congratulations to Zander, to Cyrus's for Found Soul, for best cinematography, and then for best editing and edit by Pranchu. And then best Yulipo, Steven's FaceTime. So we will get back to you guys on what little special treats we have for you guys. We'll get back to you guys on that. And then, yeah, without further ado, I've been Dominic. I've been your historian / one meeting videographer for the semester. So yeah, but I had a blast this semester, just to kind of like to wrap it up and hand it to our presidents here. I had a blast this semester. Thank you guys for showing up for every single meeting. Just showing up. Honestly, this has been a really weird semester. It's very unprecedented. And the fact that you guys still showed up, still showed stuff for show and tell, submitted film challenges that we had out. I just really appreciate that, just from the bottom of my heart. So again, I've been Dominic. I'll see you guys. I won't lose contact with you guys, but yeah. Yeah. So I'm gonna hand it off to Ariel and Max now.
Thank you, Dom. And yeah, thank you, everyone. I really couldn't say it any better, you know, myself. This has been really, really rocky. So we thank you guys for your patience, and we thank the people who've been coming to the meetings and just kind of, you know, showing every week and talking. It's been really nice to kind of have a community to come back to. And, you know, I can't wait to come back next semester and start up again, you know, talk about how we spent the summer and inside, I don't know. But, you know, it's all in all, I think it's been really great. And I really love seeing what people are creating. And, you know, it always just like gives me so much insight on seeing what like peers are making. Cause it's just like, goddamn, like I always look at what other friends, I'm like, why can't I do that stuff? Like, why am I not talented? But, you know, it just, it's inspiring. So thank you guys for coming every week and bringing your best and, you know, bearing with us, you know. Yeah, we're gonna miss you.
Yeah, I mean, Ariel kind of took the words out of my mouth. I couldn't agree more. This has been a great, even though this hasn't been the best semester, I am glad that what we could do was see you guys and see what you guys have done and kind of have these clubs to help you guys kind of just take your mind off the hecticness of what's going on in the world right now. Congratulations to all the winners. And everyone's films in general, even the ones who didn't win, you guys did a great job. Don't think just because you didn't win an award doesn't mean you didn't do a good job, because you did. I can't wait to see you guys next semester and hear what you guys did over the summer.
We're gonna, you know, reach out probably over the weekend to give you guys your certificates so that you can, you know, add this, you know, film festival on your film's resume. You can say that you submitted and you got an award for it. So we'll send you those certificates via email. So we'll reach out to you. And then for the people who won prizes, you know, this semester for past challenges in the club, and then also Zander, the grand prize, we're going to reach out to you guys and figure out what email you want us to send that prize to. So thank you guys so much. Thank you to my board who like helped me out and helped us out. And, you know, I could not have done any of this without you guys. And, you know, I'm not the best talker all the time or anything. So yeah, y'all are fam. And then the people who came to the meetings, y'all just make me so happy. Does anyone on the board have anything they want to add? You know, I can honestly say like this club could not have happened without like everybody who's here.
Yeah, I can.
Yeah, and I mean, I want to give a special shout out to Jason King. This is someone who was on our board from the very beginning, and he's helped us out from literally any kind of tech thing, like this whole live stream that's going on right now, like going through the Zoom and the YouTube and everything. Like it really is all thanks to him, because we ran like test streams like months back trying to figure this whole thing out. But I just want to give a special shout out to him. He's the mastermind behind this whole tech live stream thing. So I just want to give a shout out, special shout out to him. So yeah.
So thank you guys. Thank you, Jason. Jason, where are you at?
Okay, well, so thank you guys for coming, and you know, have a great summer. Thank you for having a great semester, and hopefully we'll see you next semester in the film club. Bye, y'all.
Bye, everyone.